What stops them? It's the brakes, of course. The earliest carriage or coach brakes consisted of nothing more than a chain which was wrapped around the spokes to lock and skid the wheel downhill. Modern automobile brakes are a far cry from the original wagon chains. But in order to see how and why the brakes stop a modern car and how they work, let's look farther into them and see what happens when we step on the brake pedal. The leverage of the brake pedal lever makes it possible to apply a great deal of pressure to the braking system with only a light foot pressure. In the most advanced designs, the brake pedal is connected to the frame of the car, strong, safely anchored, and free from engine vibrations. All brake pedals work practically the same way. The most important part of a good braking system is the brake itself. That's what really stops them. Let's look inside this brake. The size of the brake drum is mighty important. It must be wide and large in diameter so that there will be the most possible surface for the brake lining to contact. Chevrolet engineers found out that ordinary steel brake drums were often scorched by the heat from the friction between the lining and the drum. So they developed a special heat-resisting steel from which the brake drum is made. Thousands of different combinations of brake drum and brake lining materials were tested until they found the one that they knew would wear the longest and hold the best. The composition of the lining is very important. When the foot pedal is pushed down, this little cam turns like this. It pushes the brake shoes outward and against the drum. And here's a very interesting point about this brake. Two links, which swing from a stationary point, have their outer ends connected to these far ends of the brake shoes. Because these far ends of the brake shoes can swing free, the force from the cam pushes the brake shoes and linings against the brake drum with equal pressure all around. That's what really stops the car. Full gripping surface all around. In addition, this design makes the linings wear evenly and adds greatly to their life because the two links make the brake shoes self-adjusting in full contact with the brake drum under all operating conditions whenever you step on the brake pedal. The efficiency of a brake is always decreased if sand, dirt, mud, and rain get between the lining and the brake drum. So another mighty important part of the brake drum is this flange that protects the lining from wear. This flange forms a little gutter in which water and dirt are collected when they enter at the top of the drum. The mud and water are carried around to the bottom side where they run out. In this manner, the brake drum and lining are kept clean and dry, so this seal ensures smooth and efficient operation in all weather. For long life and dependability, all operating parts must be plated with either zinc, chromium, or cadmium. Such materials keep rust from weakening the brakes. These brakes are the finest you can get. The action of both the pedal and the drum must be mechanical, regardless of what's used to connect them. Brake controls are very important, although too much emphasis is often put on that subject at the expense of all that is most important, the size and strength and mechanical dependability of the brake itself. The connections between the brake pedal and the brake drums must be strong and absolutely dependable. They must be flexible enough to absorb road shocks without getting out of shape, yet they must have solid strength. Brakes are always most important in an emergency, so good brake controls must always work. They must be long-lived, and they must wear long and well. Steel cable is not affected by weather, road shocks, or deterioration. A steel cable is sure and gives positive action, and the wear on a steel cable is negligible. Strong steel cables provide powerful, unfailing, and flexible connections between the brake pedal and the brake itself. Even if we were to disconnect one, two, or even three of the cable-controlled brakes, there is sufficient power in the fourth brake to ensure stopping the car. Such cable control brakes are smooth, dependable, positive, and safe.